just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
see Guillory hit there, say, welcome, superintendent, welcome.
Wait, it's not pomp and circumstance.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah,
okay.
Versus.
Okay.
Yep.
But it's, yeah. All right, then I'm going to, okay.
So you start with this.
Yeah, I'm going to, okay.
And then once the students are starting to process, then I'll say this piece.
Beautiful. Yeah, I will tell you when. You'll see them right there.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to wait until both lines are right up at the corner, and then you say the now.
But they stand perfect. First, not when the graduates come?
They can stand whenever, yeah, they can rise. Yeah.
So I think they should rise when the graduates come, don't they?
You think they should rise when the superintendent is that
comes? All right. So I'll wait for your cue, Hal. All right, then I'm going to...
Should I even say all this right here?
Yeah, no, because I think I have to say it unless you want to.
1 minute ready.
This.
No. So wait, what are you gonna do? You gonna do this too?
You do that.
No, but you need to introduce yourself. You need to put that in there.
Declan Tracy, is that the only Declan you know?
Okay.
Lost his car.
Good afternoon. Welcome everybody to this gorgeous day. My name is Lisa Redding. I'm one of the associate deans for the class of 2022. Welcome to the Brookline High School commencement for the class of 22. Please rise if you are able. Superintendent Dr. Linus Guillory. Welcome members of our school committee. Welcome members of the Brookline High School administration. And welcome members of our Brookline High School faculty and staff. Moment you have been waiting for. Welcome to Brookline High School's class of 2022. Thank you.
Good afternoon. What a glorious day. I am Maricel Figueroa Marrero, one of the associate deans for the class of 2022. And now, our Camerata Choir, led by Dr. Michael Driscoll, will perform the Star Spangled Banner. Beautiful. A huge thank you to our Camerata Choir and Dr. Michael Driscoll. Now, would the students given our international welcome please come to the stage? Everyone else, please be seated. Thank you. Thank you to our class, Marshall Sack Snyder, for leading in our soon-to-be graduates, and to Lilia Burton Patel, who could not be with us today, so Adam Luciano is standing in. Thank you. What a day. On behalf of my fellow associate dean, Dean Fig, as they call her, and our dean of students, Dean Summer Williams, welcome to this graduation ceremony. We pride ourselves on our diversity at Brookline High School. One of the many ways in which we are diverse is in the 70 languages spoken by our students in our hallways. Today, we offer you greetings in some of those languages.
Herkese merhaba. My name is Yağız Edilman and my language of origin is Turkish. Brookline Lisesi'nin 2022 sınıfının mezuniyet törenine hoş geldiniz.
Xin chào. My name is Brian. My language of origin is Vietnamese and chào. Chào mừng đến lễ tốt nghiệp của trường trung học Brookline năm 2022.
Dobar dan, my name is Nina Ivcevic and my language of origin is Croatian. Dobro došli na dodjelu diploma srednje škole u Brookline 2022. godine.
Ciao, my name is Julia, my language of origin is Italian. Benvenuti alla cerimonia di maturità per il liceo di Brookline per la classe del 2022.
Ողջույն, my name is Edward Khachatryan. My language of origin is Armenian. Բարի գալուստ Brookline-ի ավագ դպրոցի ավարտական արարողությանը.
Hello, my name is Julius. My language is Dutch. Welkom bij de diploma-uitlevering van de Brookline Hogeschool, klas van 2022.
Hola, my name is Ramon. My language of origin is the Dominican Republic. Bienvenidos a la ceremonia de graduación para Brookline High School, el año 2022.
Shalom lekulam. My name is Doreen Artsy, and my language of origin is Hebrew. Bochim abayim latekes siyum shel tichon Brookline, machzor 2022.
Salam. My name is Samir Osmani, and my language of origin is Dari. Khosh amadin da frogate BHS 2022.
Konnichiwa. My name is Aya, and my language of origin is Japanese. 2022 年度ブルックラインハイスクールの卒業式へようこそ。
Привет. My name is Alexander Shekel and my language of origin is Russian. Я приветствую вас на выпускную церемонию 2022 года средней школы Бруклайна.
Bonjour tout le monde. My name is Gabriel Barbier-Saya and my language of origin is French. Et bienvenue à la remise de diplôme de la promotion de 2022 de Brookline.
Daga hao. My name is Eric Zhao, and my language of origin is Cantonese. Fun ying lei dou Brookline go zhong, yi ling yi yi ba yi ding lai.
Azul akhatar. My name is Mehdi Bilyamoun, and my language of origin is Amazigh. Marhaban noun kimmelt ghouri, Brookline 2022.
Hello, my name is Yanni, and my language of origin is Greek. Kalos irthate stin apophytisi dis taxis tui kosidio.
Oi, gente. My name is Helena Barbosa Andres, and my language of origin is Portuguese. Fora Bolsonaro, e sejam bem-vindos à graduação da classe de, de ensino médio de Brookline de 2022.
My name is Sam Lee, and my language of origin is Korean. 2022년 Brookline 고등학교 졸업식에 와주신 걸 감사드립니다.
마르하바, my name is Jad, and my language of origin is Arabic. 아흘란 비쿰 피 타카르루 마드리스 브룩라인 레사프 2022. 샤크란.
다자하. My name is Yingquan Liu, and my language of origin is Chinese. Mandarin. 欢迎来到2022届 Brookline 高Brookline 高中毕业典礼。Sorry about that. Sorry.
남아스테, my name is Gia Katwa and my language of origin is Hindi. Ab sabko Brookline High School kaksha 2022 mein swagat hai.
Dobar den, my name is Teo Dimov and my language of origin is Bulgarian. Dobre došli na ceremonijata po završene na gimnazija Brookline High, vipusk 2022.
Hallo. My name is Simon Kaiser and my language of origin is German. Herzlich willkommen zu der Abschlussfeier der Brookline High School für die Klasse von 2022.
Alo Minglabashe. My name is Yetanawi and my language of origin is Burmese. Sorry. Natau nasane atantwa Brookline atatan chang pwe nin tabin akana ma chu so ba shin.
Namaskar, everybody. My name is Anike, and my language of origin is Bengali. 2022 shadow class jondo
Brookline High School. Snatak Anusnare Schwagatham.
My name is Cameron Lazama. I represent a multi-generational legacy of Brookline High School graduates. Welcome to the Brookline High School graduation of class of 2022.
All right, thank you seniors for that beautiful welcome. Maybe seated. We are deeply grateful to be with you today, celebrating the accomplishments of our seniors. So welcome to all of you, especially to our soon-to-be graduates. We and you know that you have all been through something to get to this day, and we cannot be more proud of you. Welcome to your graduation. This is certainly a very special day.
Warriors! Warriors! There has never been a class at Brookline High School more deserving of this title than you. Over the past few years, we have been humbled and honored to see you persevere through the most challenging times in our school's history. Pandemic, hybrid school, construction, 4 years and 46 different weekly schedules by Mr. Mason. And let's be real, racist videos, swastikas, and walkouts. We watched you stand up and say, this is not the culture we want at BHS. You told us that the culture we think we have is not currently the culture we do have. And you organized and participated in effecting change. We are so proud of you for that. And we want you to continue creating the culture you want and need in your respective spaces as you move on from BHS and out into the world.
Through it all, this class has been resilient. You have led when others would have given up. There are so many triumphs, both individual and teams, on the pitch, court, track, mat, and pool. You have soared on stages, in galleries, and in classrooms. As a class, you are the last students to hold this school's institutional memory of when the ninth graders didn't have a new building, no one called the original building 115, and science classes were all on the third floor. You had remote learning, trips canceled, no junior semi, and yet graduation day is upon us. Perseverance. We will cherish the memory of your many victories long after you have left. Congratulations, class of 2022! And now, it is my privilege to introduce to you our head of school, Mr. Anthony Meyer.
Thank you, Dimitri. Thank you, Deans Figueroa Marrero and Redding, for your introduction and for your superb stewardship of this wonderful graduating class. Welcome, Brookline High School faculty, staff, and administrators, district leaders, parents, guardians, caregivers, families, friends, and invited guests. Sunday, June 5th, 2022 is a special day and a beautiful one. We should all feel tremendous gratitude for the many individuals, departments, and community partners who helped this commencement to happen. Parks and Open Spaces, Brookline Police, Public Health, Building Department, Brookline Interactive Group, BHS custodial and clerical staff, the inimitable and already mentioned Hal Mason, and many high school and district staff members. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Most of all, good afternoon and congratulations, members of the class of 2022. Woo-hoo! I have known many of you for a very long time, and one of you since birth. And here we are together at Fisher Hill and beaming in from homes across Brookline, Boston, and likely the globe. You look beautiful, and you are beautiful. Oh, you see that? Your parents believe that that's true as well. You need to. Over the last week or so, I have attended graduation ceremonies and year-end celebrations for several Brookline High School programs. METCO, Excel, Winthrop House, African American and Latino Scholars, ACE, SWS. Seeing and hearing these events confirmed for me the many different ways our 2022 graduates create community and find havens at Brookline High School. There are many other such communities, music and athletics, dance and drama, clubs and service organizations. Each of you members of the class of 2022 has a powerful story to tell of how you arrived today, where you found your people, and how you navigated the last 4 years in ways that are uniquely yours. I am proud of each and all of you. Despite the incredible challenges of the last 4 years, your 4 years, as Dean Redding mentioned, a major building project, a global pandemic, labor strife, reckonings in our school, country, and around the world, and so much more I cannot capture here. I have simply loved working with you seniors. Here's why, with a little added advice and encouragement. You are always in process, modeling the constant growing and learning we all need to embrace. As we say at BHS, you are not done yet. We are not done yet. Embedded in this mantra is tenacity and toughness you will need as you navigate your post-BHS lives. I ask that you apply this in-processness to your relationships and to the communities you create and join. Don't give up on people. Friends, family members, future classmates, and coworkers. We're in a unique time of cancel culture, and that's dangerous and damaging in ways I can't begin to describe. Show compassion, forgive, and forge strong relationships as a result. You, class of 2022, are adolescent alchemists, turning challenge into opportunity. As my beloved colleague Jen Martin told SWS students on Friday night, prepare to fail, often and sometimes painfully. I can tell you from individual and institutional experience that within these failures and struggles are myriad opportunities to get stronger, become better, and do the next right thing. Grow strong necks, keeping your chins up, and yourself and others moving forward, especially amidst failure. Another reason I love you guys is you critique our adult systems and structures, identifying where the values we espouse don't match the decisions we make or the actions we take. As our English chair, John Andrews, has reminded me, another beloved colleague, reminded me repeatedly this spring, this is what we explicitly ask you to do as we began the year by reading Bryan Stevenson's Just Mercy. Such criticism doesn't always feel good, and your perspectives and powerful voices are what this school, community, and larger world needs. Thank you, and keep fighting for what is right, just, and fair. Thank you. Lastly, and perhaps most importantly, love yourself and those around you. That's the word I heard most often in the couple of the year-end ceremonies over the last week. We need a whole lot more love, and there is no better group to spread that love than the Brookline High School class of 2022. Thank you, graduates. I love who you are and who you are becoming, and I will miss you very, very much. All right. So we're gonna do something different, and you're probably wondering, why am I still speaking? Didn't I just end? That's a fair thought. We're going to honor our Lincoln medalists. So we're adding a piece to the program, a recognition of our Lincoln Medal winners in the class of 2022. William H. Lincoln medals are the most prestigious awards that BHS can bestow upon a student. They have been in existence for almost a century. They are awarded to the student deemed to be the most proficient, regardless of year of graduation, in their academic disciplines. I ask each of our Lincoln Medal winners in the class to stand when I call your name and to remain standing. Josue Anselm, Career and Technology Education, 2022. Lilia Burton Patel, Biology and French, 2022. Hoping she appears here. Chu Chu Zhang, Latin, 2022. Sorry, Isla Chasen, Music, 2022. Claire Gallion, Japanese, 2022. Also the voice of Brookline High School. Carly Grossman, Mathematics and Physics, 2022. Helen Huang, Visual Arts, 2022. Benjamin Levy, Chemistry, 2021. Thomason Schmaltz, Drama and English, 2022. Rebecca Cheruz, Spanish, 2022. Oliver Slayton, Dance, 2022. Daphne Tilleman, Chinese, 2021. Ansley Washburn, U.S. History, 2021. Class of 2022 Lincoln Medal winners, we offer you congratulations for your incredible scholarship. All right. It is now my pleasure to introduce the chair of our school committee and a Brookline High School graduate himself, Mr. David Perlman.
Hello, graduates. It is my honor as a Brookline alum to be welcoming you today to the class of 2022 graduation. 22 years ago yesterday, I was sitting out here where you are, and I was cherishing the moment, looking forward to charting my future. But as you can see, I'm still involved in Brookline, and I hope that every single one of you will continue to remain a part of this community, because as you chart your futures, also remember your past, your present, and who helped bring you here. So on behalf of the school committee, I welcome you here today for your graduation. Thank you very much. Congratulations on a job well done.
Warriors. It is now my honor to introduce to you your first student speaker, Oliver Slayton. Come on up.
Hello, class of 2022, friends and family. I'm Oliver Slayton, and I use they, them pronouns. It is absolutely wild to be standing here today at what feels like such an enormous ending, yet also such an exciting beginning. I'm leaving BHS feeling galvanized by the work that I did here. I've been involved in the GSA, the dance department, SWS, and I have made some amazing friends along the way. As I hope that you have, I found my way through BHS through my 4 years here, but it was not always easy. Had you asked me what the 4 years ahead would look like while I was standing on Greeno Street on that first day of freshman year, I would have told you that I had low expectations for myself. I spent years thinking that I could never be anything more than mediocre. Brookline imposter syndrome got me, just as I'm sure it did you. When I was younger, I was a slow bloomer when it came to reading. I struggled to pay attention in class, and our traditional gender binary version of school left me feeling left out. Even at the end of my freshman year, I felt that I could get through high school, but certainly not thrive. Back then, I was completely oblivious to the fact that I was not alone in this feeling. High school is really hard. Freshman year posed new challenges for all of us, leading us to question our interests, motives, and goals. Heading into sophomore year, I was in need of some reinvention, just as I'm sure many of you were. I found my home in SWS, just as many of you have on your golf team, Mario Kart Club, student-run production, psychology class, or even the library. When I joined School Within a School, I was seeking motivation and passion in my education. SWS was a place where I was told that, yes, I was good at school, and still, there was so much room for me to grow. By the second semester of sophomore year, I felt like I had hit my groove in SWS. I enjoyed writing for the first time in my life. I was having fun with my new friends, and I actually felt good about the work that I was doing in school. Everything felt like it was going so well, and then we all got a call on March 13th, 2020. All that we had been working for felt like it was coming crashing down. I worried that the break in my routine meant nothing but ruin for my budding success. How are we supposed to learn from home? What about all of the things that we like to do? How would we survive without the vital time that we spend with our friends? I remember having a little conversation with myself a few weeks into lockdown. I told myself that I could either allow myself to twist into knots as I worried about all that I felt was being lost, or I could take what I was being given and find a way to be productive. I rolled up my sleeves and everything got kind of intense. School was the only thing that we could put our energy into. Our extracurriculars were canceled, our hobbies were remote, and we were all exiled to our bedrooms due to the virus. Junior year was filled with awkward Zoom classes, questionably executed remote bio labs, and lots of creative solutions to unprecedented logistical problems. When we tell the story of our high school experience to our kids one day, we will look back and laugh at ourselves for logging into class from our beds, but the urge to stay in a horizontal position was too great to resist. We learned to adapt to our ever-changing schedule, endless bad news from around the country, and some deep examination of societal and social issues. We survived a year when school could best be described as an ambiguous glob of learning, 15-minute transition times, and lots of questionable internet connections, whether genuine or convenient. We got through it, and we are all different because of it. This year, we showed up for the change that we saw that the world desperately needs. We learned and are continuing to learn how we have played a role in the institutional racism of not only our school, but our country as a whole, and how we can change these systems from the inside out. We used our voices to fight for our peers who are being silenced around the country for their queer identities, showing that no matter what virus, politician, or absence from class gets in our way, we will always stand up for one another. We took a stand for the people's right to reproductive autonomy while monumental court cases are brought into question. We spoke up about unjust violence around the world, whether close to home or thousands of miles away. We learned that we have loud voices that were built to be used, and we use them to make our school, our town, and each other better than we found them. One of my personal beliefs is that we never fully arrive at a final version of who we are, but rather we are constantly living as a version of ourselves who we should be right here and right now. Now, I'm a co-facilitator of GSA. I co-directed progressions and I was a leader in SWS, and I'm soon to be off to college. The version of me that strutted down the halls these past few months of high school could not have been further from the one who stood on Greeno 4 years ago. I look back at how much I have changed in my time at BHS, and I can't help but wonder how you have too. If I went from someone who attended school out of obligation to someone who just enthusiastically signed up for another 4 years of it, I can only imagine what metamorphosis has taken place in your lives. Did you find out that you love science? Did you discover new passions that you'll follow in the future? Did you become an SWS weirdo like me? As we leave BHS and head into the future, I'm excited to see how we all change. Not into the people who we will be forever, but into the versions of ourselves that have adapted to the new challenges that we will face in the future. As we look back on our 4 years at BHS, let's recall the versions of ourselves that we have left in the past, but let's not look back in shame. I look back and see a kid with braces, rainbow hair, and a snatched up ponytail who was overwhelmed by the possibilities that high school presented them with. I am proud of that person for facing high school head on and seeing where it took them. We were all facing unique and intimidating challenges, and based on the fact that you are sitting here today, you faced them with grace and overcame them. Let's be thankful for the versions of ourselves that have gotten us to this moment, and embrace the idea that we are soon to evolve into yet another stage of who we are. 4 years from now, we will look back at the versions of ourselves right now and laugh. Why were we so stressed? What were we so nervous about in the future? To wrap up, I will ask something of you all. Let's all take a moment this afternoon as we officially shift into our alumni status and reflect on who we are now in relation to who we were 4 years ago. Now, maybe even take a moment to ponder who you might be tomorrow, 4 years from now, or even at our 50th reunion. Now get ready to go find out who that person will be, because we've already slayed this beast. Congratulations, class of 2022, we did it.
Thank you, Oliver. Beautiful speech. And now for our first musical selection, singing When We Were Young by Adele, Sophia Valenzon, accompanied on the piano by Jai Jo.
Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. And everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home, you're like a dream come true. If by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go? 'Cause I've been by myself all night long, hoping you're someone I used to know. Sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you in this light, in case it is the last time that we might be exactly like we were before we realized we were sad of getting old. It made us restless. Just like a movie, it
was just like a song. And I was so scared to face my fears. Nobody told me that you'd be here. And I swear I moved overseas. That's what you said when you left me. Still look like a movie. You still sound like a song. My God, this reminds like a movie. It was just like a song when we were young, when we were young, when we were young, when we were young. It's hard to let you back just in case it takes me back to when you were there. Like a movie, it was just like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Oh, when we were young, when we. Like a song when we were young, when we were young.
Sophia, Jai, I know I'm not the only adult with teary eyes right now, right? I know, that was beautiful. Our students are so talented. And speaking of talent, I have the privilege of introducing our next student speaker, Lyris Alfred, come on up. Hello, everyone.
Class of 2022, we know it's been a long time coming. You experienced high school during an uncanny time, a raging pandemic, passionate protests, and so much more. Despite all challenges that life has relentlessly thrown at you, You've managed to conquer it all. Was it easy? No. Was it worth it? Absolutely. Brookline High School has blessed me with three valuable life lessons that I'd like to share with you all. Lesson number one. It doesn't matter how many people around you believe in your ability to succeed and thrive. If you don't believe in yourself, you'll be very limited. You would have made yourself a prisoner to that familiar, small, and rigid box inside your head. You would have been locked inside a cell of your own creation, handcuffed by your fear of failure, and hopelessly gazing out at the opportunities that only appear to be so far, but are a lot closer than you realize. I can remember walking down these halls, skimming flyers, and listening to my teachers and friends trying to encourage me to take the next step. Just try it, they tell me. I was always too afraid. I get the infamous thoughts like, what if I fail? What if I'm not good enough for this opportunity? Surely there's somebody better qualified, someone smarter, someone who deserves this more than I do. I look back at these moments and wish I'd used these thoughts as reason to take these risks. I only started to pry open my box this year. Whenever I glance at a Canvas notification or an email about a new and exciting opportunity, I try to whip up more reasons as to why I should jump in headfirst than reasons as to why I shouldn't. I think I can safely say that I'm getting better at this, considering the fact that I'm standing up here in front of all of you. Although I haven't mastered this yet, this is the first step of many. Lesson number two, focus on yourself. When you're in a school as big as Brookline High, it's difficult to not fall victim to comparison. I think for many people, including myself, senior year was a prime time for that. It can be as simple as trying to sneak a peek at your neighbor's score on a test, checking people's Instagram bios to see where they're going. Yep. And comparing college resumes to see who's been the busiest. It's a toxic cycle that swallows you whole and only allows you to view the world through your foggy lenses. I think it's important to recognize that the person sitting next to you in class is most likely trapped in their own cell. They may have different writings on the walls, but you and them still have something in common. You're both stuck in a competition that never was. We know it, it was a race to the top. Who can have the highest GPA, the best athletic skills, lead the most clubs, get the most internships? I mean, who cares? What some of us fail to acknowledge is that it doesn't matter what everyone else is doing. Never has, never will. I'm talking to all of you in myself. What everyone else is doing does not matter. Lesson number three, stick to your own path. I know that some of you might not have an idea of what that is yet, but that's okay. When you feel as though you aren't doing enough in your own world, it's easy to get distracted by someone else's. You might start believing that the key to excelling at anything or getting into your dream school is to follow someone else's lead, to follow a path other than your own. Can I let you in on a little secret? Walking down a path that doesn't belong to you will not magically lead you to your destination. This is not Wizard of Oz, although I wish it was, because I think we could all use a Toto in our lives. But back to my point, following someone else's path will leave you feeling utterly dissatisfied and lost. So I ask you to be brave. Do what your heart desires, despite what your peers are doing. Stop side-eyeing your neighbor's test. Stop checking people's Instagram and LinkedIn profiles. But most importantly, stop comparing your achievements to others. Success should not be measured by the number of activities you've listed on your Common App or the grades you've received on your report card. It definitely should not be measured by what college you go to. The mentality I'm trying to adapt is, if you made it from point A to point B, regardless of what that final stop may be, you should be celebrated. Be proud of the little things, the major milestones, the setbacks that ultimately pushed you even farther and helped you realize your true potential. Class of 2022, I believe in you, and you should too. You're moving on to bigger and better things. Keep your eye on the destination, but value your journey. Do whatever task that scares you the most, because living inside the same four walls will not foster growth. Thank you.
Yes, Lyris, we are celebrating you with that wonderful speech. Thank you. And now for our second musical selection, performing Silly Little Love Song by Joshua Redman, Jack Broomhead, Jai Joel, and Micah Lansing.
Thank you.
Amazing. Thank you, Jack, Jai, and Junior Micah for coming out on graduation. And on the drums, performing arts teacher extraordinaire, Carolyn Castellano. I would now like to invite Lily Lockwood up, who is standing in for Yuki Hoshi today. Lily?
Good afternoon, friends, families, teachers, faculty, and fellow graduates. My name is Lily Lockwood, and I, she, her pronouns. The following introduction was originally written by my friend and fellow classmate, Yuki Hoshi. Unfortunately, she is unable to attend today's ceremony and has asked that I address you all in her place. Luckily for me, we've had similar experiences at BHS, so I've been able to keep the essence of what she had written. Yuki, Lilia Burton Patel, and myself led BHS's Asian Pacific American Club, more commonly known as APAC, this year. After having joined as soon as we possibly could, we were excited to be able to take the club to new heights in our senior year. APAC has been a home to us and many others for the past 4 years. It is a community full of amazing people, so filled with ambition and love for one another. Joining APAC has also opened doors that I didn't even know existed. Last August, along with the South Asian Student Association and the Brookline Asian American Family Network, we co-hosted the inaugural AAPI Community Welcome. Approximately 300 people were in attendance with food, music, and pure AAPI joy. Just last month, a team of us presented to BHS educators on how AAPI stories could be included in our school's English and history curriculums. It was through APAC that I found my passion for community organizing and social justice. I found my people, my place at BHS, and my future. All of this would never have existed without one incredible teacher. I would like to tell you about a certain individual who has made APAC particularly special for me and many others. That is Ms. Leifwa Shorter. Ms. Shorter has been at BHS for 25 years and is the backbone of BHS's AAPI community. Ms. Shorter was the APAC advisor for 14 years, welcoming me and many of my peers into the club our freshman year. She very deservingly won Brookline's 2019 Woman of the Year Award. She has translated and published a Pulitzer-winning book by Daniel Golden called The Price of Admission, has written 33 articles about education in America for her hometown e-newspaper in China, which has 3.8 million views, and on top of that, she also has a popular YouTube account. She's an astonishingly accomplished woman who can and does do anything she sets her mind to. That is why it is even more meaningful that she has spent her time and energy at BHS. We've been so lucky to have Ms. Shorter as a teacher, an advisor, a supporter, a mentor, an in-school mother, an auntie, and more. She's the reason Yuki and I were able to find ourselves at BHS, as I imagine she is for countless other students over the years, whether that be in her Chinese classes, APAC, or elsewhere. Ms. Shorter, thank you, and we love you. And now, please welcome this year's faculty commencement speaker, Ms. Leifwa Shorter.
Now it's too late to change my speech because I'm about to roast you. I have a list of names of students who still owe me homework. I sent multiple Canvas messages before grades closed on Wednesday. Guess what? No response from some of you. Should I call their names out? Yeah? Some of you probably are feeling pretty nervous. Well, I'll do that later. Congratulations, class of 2020. From now on, you will never, ever get another Canvas message from your teachers. You are officially grown-ups. Whether your next journey is working, taking a nap, or taking a gap year, not a nap, you could do that. Or going to college, no one will ever see you or know you the way we do. As your high school teachers, even though we know that you are the so-called young adults, we are also very aware that you're not quite done yet. We remember how intimidated and overwhelmed you were when we clapped you in on the first day of high school 4 years ago. We know that your life outside of the classroom always seemed more interesting and important to you. Even when you are sitting in the classroom and supposedly paying attention to our well-crafted lessons, you have social media to browse, text messages to respond to, and of course, the latest cool game to play on your precious cell phone. Sometimes you're just too busy to do your homework. So we don't mind sending you gentle reminders. Sometimes we accept your late homework long after the due date. Other times we stay after school to help you finish one final assignment before grades close. Somehow we always find ways in our heart and mind to look beyond your imperfections because we remember the younger version of you and we know how far you have come. Well, kids, from this day forward, you are truly grown-ups, citizens of the world. And it's a jungle out there, so get ready. I have no doubt that the next chapter of your life will be more exciting as you navigate through different adventures. I do have one piece of advice to offer. This advice actually came from one of your peers, Alex, sitting right here in the front row. His departing words to the underclassmen were, "Do not underestimate your power." Remember that, Alex? Yes. I'm not sure how serious Alex was because he said it during the annual senior roast of the Chinese program. But I agree with the statement. Each one of you has a power to make a difference. You have used your collective power to challenge the status quo and demand institutional changes, such as a safe and respectful environment for all students, and a more inclusive, empowering, and modernized curriculum in our classrooms. I hope more changes will come. Now I want to talk about the other power that each one of you has, the power of words. We all know that words can unite and divide us. They can uplift or destroy spirits. We know too well that words can inflict pain and they leave a long-lasting impact on people on the receiving end. "I am sorry" or "I didn't mean to" does very little to heal a wound. So be aware of the power of your words and be intentional about how you use that power. Be kind to yourself and be kind to each other. At the end of the day, we are all human beings trying to live our lives to the fullest. Before I close, I want to give a shout out to two groups of students who are dear to my heart. The first group is students that Zhang Laoshi and I had the privilege to teach and share our passion for Chinese language and culture with. The second group is my APEC loves, members of the Asian Pacific American Club. We celebrated our heritage together. We leaned on each other to get through some really difficult times. To all my students, we share a special bond that only a few could understand. I love what I do because of you. I want to be better and do better because of you. Finally, to all members of class of 2022, congratulations, best of luck in your next journey. We will cherish the memories that you have left behind. We love you and we will miss you. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Shorter. And we will miss you upon your retirement. It is now my pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker, who is a Brookline High School graduate, class of 2007. When he was in high school, he was an Earn a Bike participant at Bikes Not Bombs. That's a social justice institution that specializes in collecting and repurposing bicycles to create job opportunities and to grow a culture of sustainable transportation. He is now the executive director of this nonprofit organization. In between, he was a teacher through the Teach for America program, and he taught in our ACE program at BHS. He holds a bachelor's degree in African American history and Spanish linguistics from UMass, and a certificate in nonprofit management and leadership from Boston University's School of Business. It is a real pleasure to bring back our keynote speaker, Mr. Elijah Evans.
Class of 2022, how does it feel? You're almost there. I have the joy of being the last speaker before you get your diplomas. I promise I'll be brief. Good afternoon, everyone. Dean Redding, Head of School Meyer, Superintendent Guillory, thank you so much for the opportunity to be here today. My name is Elijah Evans. For the last 5 years, I've served as the Executive Director of Bikes on Bombs, a nonprofit in Jamaica Plain. Since 2003, I've witnessed the incredible growth of the organization. At the same time, Bikes on Bombs has been a huge part of my leadership journey. Class of 2022, I am so grateful to share this day with you and your families as you celebrate your journey and accomplishments here at BHS. We are truly living through extraordinary times, and that calls for extraordinary leadership. I think it's safe to say we're all looking to you to be leaders of today. I want to start by sharing three important things. First and foremost, I want to give thanks to God and my mom for getting me this far. Second, I have to say, without the MECRO program, I literally wouldn't be the leader that I am today. It is because of Dr. Jean McGuire, Janet Morris, Susie Talukdar, Chris Vick. In fact, Dr. Vick actually helped me make the decision to go to UMass by helping me reflect on what was most important to me. That was, of course, not before pitching Morehouse, which I appreciated. I wanted to follow a similar path that Paul Epstein has taken, staying and making a lasting impact in my community, as he has done here in Brookline. I also want to shout out, clap it up. Paul is doing the real work. I also want to shout out our graduating MECO students. Can I ask you all to rise, please, and everybody clap it up for them. And then I also want to give a shout out to Keith Lazama and Malcolm Cawthorn for carrying the torch forward. The third important thing is I have a critical question, and I'll ask it toward the end of my remarks, which, full transparency, will be about 10 minutes. A bit about me and my background. I was born in Brooklyn, and raised in Boston by a single mom from the island of Trinidad and Tobago, who worked tirelessly as a nurse to provide for my family and my education. My middle name is Mandela, and that has always served as a sense of pride for me. Nelson Mandela once said, "To be free is not merely to cast off one's chains, but to live in a way that respects and enhances the freedom of others." He is undoubtedly one of the most effective liberation leaders of our time, and is probably the first example of a leader that I can remember, someone who puts the needs of others before themselves. As you all sit here today, I'm sure you're reflecting on what the past 4 years have been like. And I know the pandemic has really had a real impact on that. 15 years ago, I was in your shoes, sitting in the audience at graduation, anxious and unsure about the next chapter of my life. While many of my classmates knew what was next for them, I was still figuring out my plan. I spent the entire senior year agonizing about what school I would attend in the following year. And it was painful. The weight of the decision increased every time I'd see one of my friends running into the MECRO room with a new acceptance letter or rocking their new college swag. We didn't have Instagram then. I felt lost, and to be honest, somewhat embarrassed. I was always a good student, but like most teens, I was also good at masking my emotions. Albert Einstein once said, "Life is like riding a bicycle. In order to keep your balance, you must keep moving," which I took literally. So at our graduation ceremony in 2007, I played the Star Spangled Banner on the steel drum. I got my diploma and I kept it moving. That was the end of my time at BHS, or so I thought. Little did I know I would not only return to BHS as a leader, but I would also be able to serve as the history teacher in the ACE program. Shout out to ACE, by the way. It's an incredible community. And by the way, that year was quite a year to be a history teacher. It was during the historic 2016 election. And it's safe to say, I think history teachers are so underappreciated. We need to appreciate them a little bit more. A huge shout out to Kara Lopez and Amy Beyer for giving me a chance. It's also so incredible to continue to be embraced by this extraordinary community. Class of 2022, this brings me to my first piece of advice. Cherish your mentors. Cherish your role models, the folks who define your community, the folks who helped you along the way, starting with your families, of course, and also your teachers, your counselors, social workers, support staff, deans, school and town leaders, and friends. Let's show them some love. Let's clap it up for your community. You wouldn't be here without them. A respected educator, Rita Pearson, who did a famous TED Talk, says, "Every child deserves a champion, an adult who will never give up on them, who understands the power of connection and insists they become the best they can be." So, and this is the last series of shout outs, I promise. I just want to take a moment to shout out some of the champions in my life, folks whose shoulders I stand on. I want to show love to Ellen Hers, my phenomenal guidance counselor. I know she's some of yours as well. Also, some of the phenomenal teachers I had, Deans Underwood and Cradle, Corey Whitfield, Kristen Murphy, Elon Fisher, Keith Thomas, Megan Kennedy Justice, Kathy Hitchcock, who's retiring, Shelly Maines, Paul Priestley, all of whom continue to do incredible work for the BHS community. All of you, and too many more to mention, were instrumental in my journey to leading Bikes Not Bombs, a 38-year-old organization that uses the bicycle as a vehicle for social change to achieve economic mobility for Black and other marginalized people in Boston and the Global South. In 1984, Bikes Not Bombs' founder sent recycled bicycles to the people of Nicaragua during a violent civil war. Some of you might have heard of the Iran-Contra scandals related to that. We were quite literally bikes, not bombs. Since then, we've evolved to understanding bombs to mean more than just physical bombs, but also the metaphorical bombs of oppression and injustice. And there's no denying that today, our communities are facing bombs that are rooted in the same systems of oppression that our organization confronted at the time of our founding, like climate change and white supremacy. Bikes Not Bombs' founders were driven by a sense of solidarity with the people of Nicaragua. I'm guessing it's the same sense of solidarity that propelled every single one of you to participate in a walkout earlier this year. Or when your teachers, who some might say followed your lead and held a strike in order to finalize their contract. That is the kind of leadership that would make Mandela proud. You all should be proud. For me, the path to leadership has been a journey. I vividly remember my first day at Bikes Not Bombs. I was a shy 14-year-old kid. I was at the Runkle School, and my reluctance to try out the Earn a Bike program only magnified as I stepped out of the rain into a scrappy bike shop cluttered with wheels, tools, and tires. But then everything shifted. I entered the Earn a Bike space. Within the chaos of bike parts was a vibrant group of young people who welcomed me. In MECO, while I had access to a great education and network of friends, I often felt torn between two really different communities. In Brookline, I was too Black. In Dorchester, I wasn't Black enough. I didn't realize it then, but I was searching for a community. At Bikes Not Bombs, staff and peers immediately embraced me, appreciating me for what I could contribute. I knew I belonged. When that first program ended, I was motivated to do whatever it took to remain connected. So I signed up to volunteer, and 1 year later, I landed my first job ever, teaching other youth in Earn a Bike, and then later working in our bike shop. I was so proud, I started to see myself as a leader, making change every single day. When I joined Teach for America in 2014, I taught eighth grade social studies in Chelsea, Massachusetts, one of our gateway cities. The moment I first realized the dream of teaching could come true was teaching Earn a Bike at Bikes Not Bombs. That's powerful. Class of 2022, this is my second and final piece of advice. There are two mantras that I learned from Teach for America that I share and offer to you today. Start with why and trust the process. Although I wanted a job, I knew I wouldn't stand out when I applied for one at Bikes Not Bombs if that was my only motivator. Because many youth that we engage want and deserve a job. For me, I decided it was more important to show that I was reliable and committed to the mission. And if I could prove myself, the job would eventually come. And it did, and the rest is history. Start with why, trust the process. A clear why paints a clear vision and propels leaders to act as catalysts for social change. I am extremely proud to be part of a movement that lifts voices, advances economic mobility, nurtures communities, and changes lives. Class of 2022, this is the important question. Are you a leader? If so, please stand. Are you a leader? And stay standing for a moment. Look around you and consider, who are the leaders around you? How can we support one another? How can we create sustainable change? How can we develop more leaders? John Quincy Adams once said, if your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more, then you are a leader. I think it's time we do away with this notion that young people are the future. We need fresh ideas now. We need fresh perspective now. And the only way that that happens is when we establish and embrace a culture where your leadership is valued, because you are more than capable, and honestly, sometimes you're better at leading. Today, I invite you to join us. We need leaders in the movement. You may be seated. So just to recap my advice to you, cherish your mentors, cherish your community. Start with why and trust the process. As I close, I leave you all with the same quote by former First Lady Rosalynn Carter that I included under my yearbook photo in 2007. A leader takes people where they want to go. A great leader takes people where they don't necessarily want to go, but ought to be. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Can we take a moment and thank Elijah Evans again for those remarkable words? Oh. All right, things have been exciting and are about to get super exciting. As the head of school of Brookline High School, it is my honor to present the class of 2022, not sure why I'm trying to slow us down a little bit. As having met the requirements of Brookline High School and the public schools of Brookline, and now I introduce to you the leader of the public schools of Brookline and my boss, Dr. Linus Guillory.
Dr. Dorothy Height once said, stand up to be seen, speak up to be heard, and sit down to be appreciated. So I'm going to try to take that advice and be extremely brief with you today. Head of School Meyer, as superintendent of schools, it is my distinct pleasure to receive the graduating class of 2022. It is indeed a special honor for me to participate in this graduation ceremony today, alongside all of our wonderful students and staff of Brookline High School. What an extraordinary year it has been. The class of 2022 has shown amazing strength and resiliency over the course of their time at BHS. For 3 years, all of you have weathered the impacts of the pandemic with grace and strength. As notable national and global events rocked the world around you, you responded with dignity, hope, and action. While COVID-19 has continued to impact our lives this year and on this very day, we are so fortunate that our community joined together to adopt strategies that enabled us to continue enjoying the many extracurricular activities that make life at BHS so meaningful, including performing arts, athletics, and of course, your senior prom. Despite the challenges you faced over the last 4 years, you displayed dignity and resolve in crafting solutions. You should be proud of your efforts, and I know I speak for your families and the entire Brookline community when I say that we are incredibly proud of you. I wish you all good health, happiness, and prosperity. May you always look back upon Brookline High School fondly. We hope that we have provided you with a solid foundation upon which you can build a life of happiness and accomplishment. Congratulations to the class of 2022.
All right, everybody, the moment you've been waiting for, class of 2022. Mr. Mason, are we ready or do you want me to give you a moment? All right, class of 2022, can we give it up for these graduates? I want to make I want to clarify that I will greet each graduate. I made this announcement before on our rehearsal day last Thursday. So remember, I follow your lead. I shake your hand, I air bump you, I hug you, it's your call. And I will respond. I will be wearing a mask. However, in the brief moment that we're taking a photograph together, I'll take off my mask, just trying to keep you all safe as we navigate COVID again. So the first graduate that we're going to recognize is one of several who is participating remotely. And so it is my great honor to welcome, I hope, to the screen and that you stop seeing me soon and you see Ms. Lilia Burton Patel. Congratulations, Lilia, you're wonderful. And now I introduce Astrid Allen, who's going to be reading your names.
Good afternoon, everybody. Buenas tardes. Lilia, we miss you. All right, families and guests, get ready. It's time. first person, Luciano Adam. Jose Adler. Miriam Ahmad. Ayaka Ihara. Lyris Alfred. Rolando Alvarez. Lucas Amaral Romero. Sarmad Ameli. Jen Ray Angela Ann. Juliana Anastopoulos. Catherine Anderson. Helena Andrus. Josue Anselm. Demetrios Antoniadis. Olivier Armand. Isabella Aresti. Julius Aralovich. Natalie Aronson. Doreen Artsy. Alessandra Arvello. Sola Ash. Isabella Maria Ashton Rickhart. Giovanni Assad. Tommaso Assad. Tristan Atkins. Danye Adotori. Greg Auditore. Nina Bakum. Seraph Bales. Mehdi Belyamoun. Gabriel Barbersaya. Philip Barden. Jonah Barrer. Shane Barnes Thomas. Azavia Barsky Elnor. Gabriel Barnett. Nicholas Bass. Noah Bauman. Nora Bauman. Darius Baines. Kamini Badaria. Nina Bingham. Jade Blaze Ellis. Maxwell Blaney Petit. Irmoon Boldbatar. Davis Bonebreak. Thomas Trey Bookhart. Sasha Borkson. Daria Bordeen. Olivia Boyd. Morgan Brandel, diploma presented by parent Nicole Brandel, teacher at Baker School. Isaac Brendel. Julia Briggle. Michael Badnia. Jevanina Brinkerhoff. Anne Briney. Liza Brisbane. Helena Broadway. Jesse Brockman. Lindsay Evans Brookfield. Zoe Brooks. Jack Broomhead. Eliza Brown. Brenda Brown. Olivia Bryan. Noah Bunis. Jalisa Angelina Burgos. Ava Berkeley Woolers. Grayson Badger. Harry Casper. Declan Tracy. James Bernard. Gianna Byron. Ashayla Cancinos. Rosalia Link Caramazza. Liam Caramello. Christopher Kasim. Sebastian Cavallacci Lico. Isla Chasen. Henley Chen. Zakai Chen. Ariana Chang. Audrey Bohe Choi. Rohan Chopra. Hannah Cherwin. Annabelle Cloney. Leora Cohen. Tamima Cohen. Suzanne Ada Collins. Isis Contreras Perez. Risa Cove. Amelia Cox. Kirsten Cummings. Sahara Curry. Kate Cutler. Neelu Dadgar. Lucas Dahlborg. Twyla Daly. Brody Davidson. Jonas De Bruin. Paul Delgado. Amelia Del Camino Yang. Ty Denny. Beatriz de Sosa. Jayanth Devaya. Adriano DeMarco. Ethan Dillon. Teo Dimov. Mackinson Domerson. Katrina Dobner. Charlotte Dresser. Carolyn Driscoll. Jacob Duarte Perlovsky. Rex Dubay. We're checking our Zoom, everybody. Reconnecting. Hey, hey there. Hey, Rex. Okay, Michaela DeBreeze. Jordan Duncan. Matthew Dunham. Nicholas Jombeck. Sean Ebanks. Sarah Edelstein. Tafari Edge Wallace. Jake Edwards. Misha Efriamov. Alex Duran Madore. Sasha Efriamova. Ava Mena Ekalemu. Bella Engeland. Eliana Engerman. Owen Erdman. Oliver Erdos. Liv, oh, just kidding. There he is. They're saying there he is, everybody. Hey, there he is. Congratulations, Oliver. Liv Ernst. Noah Escobedo. Phoebe Estelle. Jesse Etkin Macias. Kate Fabry. Zoe Fagnan. Lucas Fahey. Emma Farrer. Aaron Feinstein. Aaron Feldman. Eli Feldman. Ian Ferdinand Somerville. Manuel Fernandez. Emma Finkelstein. Michelle Finkelstein. Layla Finkley. Lucas Finzi. Zachary Fish. Lauren Flaherty. George Flint. Johanna Flo. Charlotte Foote. Rachel Ford. Olivia Fox. Zach Friedman. Kendall Fries. Maya Frey. Anna Friedman. Alexander Frost. Nathaniel Fusillo.
Congratulations, graduates. New reader, Claire Gallion. Waiting for Claire. Jasmine Garcia Young. Bjorn Gardner Olson. Alessandro Gargiulo. Gregory Gatlin. Cameron Geller. Eva Georgiakis. Masha Gershenko. Leahy Gertner. Rohan Gervais. Chrysanthi Giannis-Medes. Aiden Gianetti. Gilda Gilbert. Luke Gold. Benjamin Goldfarb. Anastasia Gordon. Aaron Gordon Berryhill. Dustin Grace. Cassandra Gravina. Lyle Gray. Oliver Green. Jason Greer. Sasha Greaves. Anton Grinev. Carly Grossman. Gabriel Grossman. Eduardo Grulon. Jai Guo. Jacob Gurdon. Ella Gutnick. Evan Guttel. Evan's diploma will be presented by parent Karen Shashua from the Heath School. Jacob Halley Gilash. Yep. Lachlan Harris. Nathaniel Harris. Nathaniel's diploma will be presented by parent Lisa Lamont Harris, team facilitator and special education liaison. Sophie Harris. Raphael Hart. Maxwell Hatchett. Campbell Hawkins. Bo Hayes Pollard. Rebecca Hazen. Oliver Hecht. Isaac Heffes. Joshua Heinstein. Zoe Henrik. Paresh Hertz. Brendan Higgins. Sarah Hill. Atticus Hilt. Bastian Hincapié. Benjamin Hong. Peyton Hooks. Simone Sumire Horowitz. Yuki Hoshi, who I believe is absent. Ella Howe. Ella's diploma will be presented by Josh Howe, Vice Principal of the Baker School, and Ella's father. Greta Huang. Helen Huang. Joanne Huang. Tyler Negron Hunsinger. Jean Young Herr. Ellie Hyde. Lily Hyde. Kai Ida. Ku Ida. Luis Edelman. Katerina Ivanova. Antonia Nina Ivchevich. Helen Ives. Sanjino Jacques. Devin James. Paxton James Starr. Andrew Janowski. Emma Jarvis. Max Jepson. Bradley Jocelyn. Azam Emir Johnson. Zoe James. Not there. Jacob Johnson Weingart. There we go. Elizabeth Jones. Alexa Kalish. Sasha Calvert. Sayun Sunny Kang. Anna Kaplan. Max Jepson. He's coming. So, Azam Emir Johnson. Are we good? Is this Jad? Beautiful. Jad Kassir. Gia Katwa. Jonathan Katz. Simon Kaiser. Luca Kelly Nielsen. Ella Kelly. Jada Kelly. Edward Kachatrian. Willa Kitterman. Noah Kleiner. Noah's diploma will be presented by parent Debbie Kleiner, BEEP teacher at the Ridley School. William Knopp. Nicholas Komarnitsky. Ezra Gill Kornmeyer. Gabriel Kramer. Madhav Krishna. Nick Krivtoff. Abigail Kushner. Joseph Krasansky. Zachary Snyder. Zachary here? Zachary's diploma will be presented by Rebecca Snyder, guidance counselor at the Runkle School. Okay. Zach? Okay. Zachary Snyder. Zachary's diploma is being presented by Rebecca Snyder, guidance counselor at the Runkle School. Colin Lacayo. Charles Ladge. Isabella Lane. No.
Are you Andre?
Okay, Andre LaFon. Kiko Lancaster. Maeve Leslie. Alexander Lodano. Elliot Lazarova Wang. Hannah Lee. Joshua Lee. Samuel Lee. Hope Leshley. Griffin Lev. Jacob Levin. Cameron Lazama. Marlon Lee. Julia Liberatore. Jonah Lieberman. Luca Liebau. Emerson Lin. Haofeng Lin. Tilden Lin. Ava Linus. Max Little. Yingqing Lu. Camille Lockwood. Lily Lockwood. Ariana Lodge. Charles Long. Laura Lowe. Hong Brian Lee. Michael Lehman Weil. Jack McIver. Jack's diploma will be presented by parent Anna McIver, teacher at the Runkel School. Zoe Mack. Tyler Mahoney. Aniket Majumdar. Madeline Malloy. John Martel. Anna Martino. Natalie Matayev. Michaela Matarazza. Rafael Mata. Annika Meyer. Jaden Mazzara. Fiona McGill. Patrick McGuire. Elsie McKendry. Kellen McNamara. Carmen Mears. Haley Mejias. Ruben Mendoza. China Mercer. Victoria Grace Francis Yvonne Merritt. Annabelle Meyer. Annabelle's diploma will be presented by her father, BHS head of school, Anthony Meyer. Daniel Michelson. Olivia Meagle. Riley Miller. Riley's diploma will be presented by parent Jed Miller, BHS Coordinator of Therapeutic Supports. Alejandra Mineo Levitsky. Alexander Miranda. Lee Mitchell. Raphael Mock. Owen Malloy. Isabel Montron. Julian Moody. Tina Razi Morakabati. Edlumia Morse. Isaac Morse. Charles Musco.
Rowan Nara Simon. Olivia Nardone. Willem Neufeind Lessig. Grace Nickerson. Kaya Nickerson. Jacob No. Ahmed Noor. Anna Norman. Yunjae Norris. Alexei Nosatov. Caden Lakai Nystuen. Sophie O'Connell. Rosemary O'Farrell. Laura O'Neill. Folashade Okuju. Raquel Olson Velasco. Samir Osmani. Ryan O'Casey. Felipe Ojuela. William Palmucci. Christina Panova. Yanis Papakostas. Mia Papazian. Spencer Park. Yeah. Nicholas Parla. Sydney Pasley Harris. Roshan Patel. Karina Perez. Ramon Perez Acevedo Sanchez. Elliot Pertel. Alexander Peterson. Alexander Pisios. Daphne Pisios. Jenna Polanski. Samuel Polyakov. Fletcher Poon, presented by parents Stephanie Poon, history teacher at BHS, and Brian Poon, BHS Dean of Student Support Systems at BHS. Kairav Prabhu Schlosser. Nicholas Prelak. Vivian Ray. Avin Rai. Syed Armin Rasool. Joshua Rachel. Kelsey Raymond. Sharon Reddy. Andreas Reznikov. Vienna Rivas. Jason Rich. Matthew Richardson. Joshua Ricks. Gabriel Reeves. Ava Rizika. Felicia Robinson. Enrique Rodas. Charles Roderick. Adelaide Rowe. Eli Rothman. Raina Rose. Eleanor Rosen. Benjamin Rosenthal. Rowan Rautebush. Yeah. Shira Rosen. Frank Rumreich. Caitlin Russell. Neda Sabava. Dominic Salamon. Elijah Sandler. Yudai Satake. Patrick Scanlon. Kyle Shellis. Alexander Shinkman Bonias. Adriana Schleitman. Druva Schlondorf. Hannah Schlossberg. Thomason Schmaltz. Mila Seifert. Aaron Simonis. William Simonis. Anastasia Semyanikova. Elizabeth Sever. Maisie Jean Schaefer. Nathaniel Schwartz. Katya Shafranskaya. Maximilian Shah. Rebecca Sharuz. Aditi Shankar. Vidushi Sharma. Alexander Shekel. Emma Sciola. Miles Sherman. Liba Sheikh. Ernesto Sierra Ponce. Alexander Solis. Christy Silo. Charles Silverman. Siddhivinayak Sivamukar. Sivakumar, excuse me. Oliver Slayton. Alexander Slavinsky. Jacob Smagula. Draquan Small. Yeah. Amari Nia Smith. Hannah Smoljar. Zachary Solom. Zachary Solomon. Casey Sun. Lee Sok Song. Sophie Spaniard. Jacob Spunt. Anderson St. Clair. Audrey Stanton. John Stanton. Michaela Stenseth. Carrie Strong. Marsha Siverin. Ryo Takahashi. Jasmine Tan. Luke Thibault. Grace Thompson. Daphne Tilleman. Clara Tolkoff. Lydia Tonkoff. Riley Topper. Declan Tracy. Catherine Trogue. Nathan Turetsky. Obioma Okamadu. Kasra Varaste. Pandora Vasquez. Sophia Valenson. Danielle Villa. Sophia Villafane. Mia Vinci. Joseph Viola. Kaya Burrell Wykar. Lily Walsh. Ansley Washburn. Diploma presented by parent Tara Washburn, peer school math specialist. Mariah Washington. Caleb Weldon. Sh- Sean Wells. Miles Whalen. Taylor Whitley. Conrad Wickman. Alexandra Williams Chavaria. Benjamin Wilson. Regan Wilson. Jedina Ween. Kai Winder. Arthur Winslow. Vivian Wolf. Nikhil Wong. Stephanie Wong. Isaiah Wood. Lauren Woody. Nora Wolfwork. Chu Chu Shang. Evan Yi. Samantha Yi. Jordan Yoke. William Yoon. Emma Young. Diploma presented by Mother Jana Young, school nurse at Ridley School. Connor Young. Jocelyn Zaka, presented by parent Liz Gorman, BHS World Language Teacher. Tet Zaw. Chun Zhang. Chen Hao Zhang. Eric Zhao. Jerry Jung. Jay Joe. Adam Zolotovsky. And to conclude the list of graduates, Charlie Zucker.
It is really my pleasure as a fellow Brookline High School graduate to lead you all in the singing of our alma mater. But you don't want that. So will the members of Camerata please come up on stage? Come on. Yep, come up. All right, so class of 2022, please stand up. Your tassels should be on the right side.
Are you confirming?
No, of course not. After the singing of our alma mater, which is on the back of your program, I will turn it over to Mr. Meyer.
Are you ready, 2022 graduates? All right, you're gonna toss your cap in a minute. By the power vested in me by the school committee and by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, I am proud to say that you are Brookline High School graduates. Congratulations. Thank you, graduates, family, friends. Have a wonderful afternoon. Thank you so much.